Sawate! This is Jeff.
This is David.
And we're playing a Chaos Legion.
Yay!
Oh, hey, it's loud. Let me turn it back down. I was wondering where the sound went.
Apparently there wasn't any.
There we go. Oh. We're going to play the last level.
Yeah!
The final stage. It is going to be over forever. Hey, look at all of our stats. I've got all of the stats.
All of them.
At this point, since we spent the last video looking through bizarre ways to get those things, thought fair enough just to show off the setup here. We have maxed out all legions. That's not the menu I'm looking for. Let's just look on the side. 4-4-4-10-10. 4-4-4-10-10. 4-4-4-10-10. 4-4-4-10-10. 4-4-4-10-10. We have created the ultimate everything. We even have perfect Thanatos, which he looks sort of like a, you know, just a
still shark juice. Oh,
cut. No, he's not. He's really more like just an angel, actually.
Oh.
Story.
The awesome power of the forbidden spirit, Azrael, is going to come once again and reunite the worlds. Do you remember the last time? When the Order of Saint Avaria broke the Seal of Chaos. They wanted to harness the power for themselves. But Azrael was too powerful for them to control, so they quickly sealed Chaos once again. And then tragedy struck. Sela's death. It was your uncontrollable madness which threw me into this cruel nightmare. Why? Why? Sela's soul has been taken to the other side and is now part of Azrael. Therefore, by releasing Azrael, I will be releasing Sela as well. The seal must be broken! To complete the ceremony, you, the one who took Sela away from me, will be sacrificed. Zeke, the time has come for me to send you to the other side.
Wake up. You'll never get her back.
Silence!
By the way, I'm here. What's going on, guys? Oh! Sorry. So don't make it any worse. Interrupting something.
You're
backs
so
away.
Pathetic. Your only loyalty is to the dead.
Another surprisingly competent
I've
speech from
lost loved ones
Arcia.
To
wasn't expecting this.
I can't get them back. They will never answer my calls. Or laugh
also,
at
she just
again.
Burst in and yet she knows
you
what they were
understand.
Talking about. I'm just saying. She just got there.
Zeke, you should understand what I'm feeling. This infinite pain I suffer from.
Why are his nails
gone? Oh, by the way, now he can control people for some reason.
Psycho Mantis.
No!
I shall sacrifice your useless soul for Sela's.
Zeke! Stop him, please. Innocent people shouldn't have to suffer anymore.
Quiet!
Oh, wow. Pew. He actually... Oh. I didn't think that actually... Okay.
It's like, I just got the ability to do that for some reason in this cutscene.
All right, and now...
So now we're going to fight Delacroix. In... Whose first name is actually Victor, but... This is the same fight.
Literally?
Mm-hmm. We do get to see the... Well, a little bit of Perfect Thanatos. Perfect Thanatos' sort of moment of glory will definitely be the second fight here. Spoilers.
Oh, there's more than one. Spoilers.
Spoilers. There's more than one fight. Yeah, this is... It's surprisingly simple, this fight here. Just, you can get him to do the exact same things that he did in the first fight.
Ow. Actually, that really did hurt.
Three-hit combo. And then one last one after a short delay, and just run your face into him. He charges up, and that's his sort of counter window. Just run your face into him. But yeah, about Perfect Thanatos. Perfect Thanatos is actually smaller than Adult Thanatos. He has his huge wings. He basically just looks like a kind of an angelic form. And he curls, there he is. He curls up inside of his wings and just runs into dudes. Smack. Smack. The stupid swords got me. But whatever. Yeah, Perfect Thanatos is amusing, but also disappointing because it takes too much. It just takes too much. It's not good enough, I feel, to
make up for losing adult Thanatos.
Yeah, not even that. To make up for just not use, just use Blasphemy. Seriously, just use Blasphemy.
We've all learned your penchant for loving the little atomic soccer ball turtle.
Atomic soccer turtles. I spent a lot of this fight just standing still because I think it's more embarrassing for the boss. Just to, like, come on. Get into position. Over here. Float over here. There you go. Now we'll just do some jump slashes. Because I end up using him so much that a single hit will just, you know, instantly kill Thanatos at this point. Because he didn't have any health left. Which can be frustrating, but I mean, it's the last boss, so
whatever.
I don't feel bad about using items and stuff. Might as well. Slice.
They seem to have dealt more damage to you than he did.
Yeah. I didn't see this whole fight. It took me a few times to get, like, good versions of the fights. I don't think I've ever died, though. When you have max stats, it's very hard to die.
Right.
It's certainly a lot.
Unless you're playing on hard mode.
Yeah, unless you're playing on hard mode. But even then, if you have max health, max defense, like I do at this point, a lot of it is pretty trivial. I mean, in fact, it was kind of annoying because I would want to restart the fight, not because I died, because it didn't go very well. I was like, I got hit too many times, but I only had, you know, like a quarter of the health off.
Yeah.
So it just took forever to just sit there and wait to die, because you can't restart. Anyways, he's dead now. Oh, Victor Delacroix. Even Sila calls you Delacroix instead of Victor.
Really?
Such an intimate relationship. Yes, really. Time for more story. This has a lot of story in it.
Oh, wait.
Oh, she's not dead.
What?
Yeah, I know, right?
Lame.
You should look at that wound on her shoulder. It's not going to be there very long.
I'm alive.
You're alive.
The moment I pulled the trigger, the force restraining me weakened. Maybe Delacroix still may have some doubt in his heart.
No, he looks pretty evil.
I will never forget. I mean, did you see that? He's like, he's got like the evil stink lines coming off him. He's like, wow, 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 wow.
Your sin will be paid for with your life.
Zeke!
Again. This is stupid. This is a trope I hate in movies and video games. I even did it in True Crime, where you're like, you're across the room and someone's gonna shoot the guy, and then you jump in front of the gun when it is literally closer to jump at the gun in order to deflect the bullet's path. In this case, the sword. She was closer to Delacroix. It would be much simpler to kind of jump at his sword or jump at him.
Yeah.
Superior, I tried to see Azrael
behind the gateway of chaos. While I was struggling to see it, Azrael resisted up until the very last moment the gateway was closed.
Delacroix! Open your eyes, Delacroix!
So wait, he killed Sila?
He sure did. You think it would be easy for Zeke to perhaps mention that earlier, but...
Especially since he was going through all the guilt trippy thing? But...
I know, right?
Okay, that face is priceless.
Sila...
Zeke, you must live. And please take care of Delacroix.
Not Victor. No one knows his name is Victor. Please. It's always Delacroix.
Delacroix.
Sila!
So wait, is this like a cloud thing where actually...
Why are you
no.
sleeping?
Okay.
Sela?
So he wasn't actually the one in love with Sela.
Well, maybe.
Sela.
You can read into it what you want to, I guess.
We can't actually read into it because the books are in Japanese, but
no, we can read into it what the heck we want to. Make it some sort of bizarre love triangle for all I care.
Did I kill Sela? Did I? It's all come back. I remember everything. It was these hands that... Sela... I was the one being controlled by the darkness. Zeke, no matter what the truth is, my love for Sela will never die. The time has come to unbind Azrael, and for me to be reunited with
Sela. Oh, so he's still crazy?
And
well, you know, he's come this far. He's killed a lot of people.
I will become one with her.
Although, you know, as a Legionator, so his... Zeke, really, if you think about it. He's basically just taking people's souls and turning them into monsters so that he can fight, and Delacroix's doing the same thing.
Yeah, that's true.
The truth was revealed.
They both kind of suck.
End up this way.
The whole world kind of sucks, honestly.
Yeah.
Like, another little reason. And the little date markers on the... when it says, like, 751 AS.
Yeah.
It's for Anno Satanis.
After released. Satan?
Yes. Year of Satan. Because Japan. That's why.
What? So the world really just sucks at this point.
Yeah.
So it's like, even when, it's just like...
This has, like, my favorite boss battle music, though. The theme of Azrael.
Oh, really?
It's pretty awesome. I think it's pretty awesome. So here's Azrael. Big old last boss thing. It's, you know, you need a good last boss thing.
Oh, it's got little hands.
It's
got little Bob hands.
Azrael doesn't have that many attacks. I'm going to be mostly spamming Thanatos quite a bit. A lot of stuff.
Yeah.
You can't hear it, but it's in the background. It's got the screen going. Basically, Azrael only has two attacks. He has lasers, four lasers, which he's going to shoot out in the same sequence. You know, left, right, and then across. And then he also spawns eight missiles that will actually fire towards you and then curve back around and come at you again. Should see those in a second here. They kind of flew by already, but... Other than that, you just wail on him, because whatever, he's a chump.
Really?
We ain't gonna see no mess. He's already on his last health bar. This whole fight takes about 60 seconds. Ah, poor Thanatos got in the way of the laser. And that's why you always leave a note.
Yeah.
Just jump slash him into oblivion. It's fine. That's the missiles.
That's the missiles.
They'll curve back around. There's always the little zombies around. I would like to point out that that was a clutch dodge, missile dodge.
Nice.
And slice. There goes Azrael. The angel
that
of death.
That was ridiculously underwhelming.
Discussed that a little bit in the Darksiders LP.
Yeah,
Azrael is the angel of death.
I think the Darksiders Azrael is more intimidating than that, which I suppose.
Yeah.
Oh, and now it's Sela.
Hey, what about that? One last final boss.
Is that Sela? Supposed
that
to be
Sela? That is Sela.
Okay.
This is Demon Sela.
Sure, why not?
Monster Sela, sure.
Cool.
She has, this is the, I guess, the true last boss. The one actually has a lot of moves, can deal... crap tons of damage to you. We'll be seeing some of that.
Oh, inverted spine wings. That's good.
Sure, why not? Let's refill our soul here. But also kind of a chump. I'm not gonna lie.
Really?
Like, you can get pretty ripped up by some of her attacks, or you could just stand there quietly and wait for her to do her thing. First thing she'll do, she'll say, come out. And then you'll have a wave of enemies. This is what I mainly am using the Ignorant Masses for, because I want to get rid of the Mega Mans, basically.
Yeah.
And then it behooves you to get rid of the golems. Just don't stand in the circles. You'll be fine.
The Goliath things?
Yeah, the Goliath. So the Goliaths behooves you to get rid of them.
Oh, I thought you dodged that.
Yeah, I thought I did too. She'll occasionally do her, three concentric circles of circles.
Yeah.
The next spot,
geometry.
Yeah, the next phase, she will call out Danu's, which, and this is her one of her very long counter windows. Like, if you run into her right now, this is, okay, the laser attack. You want to run the other way. Counterclockwise, gotta remember. This is her other counter window when she dashes at you. Don't get hit by that, by the way. Anyways, she'll stay there and then watch 2.5 life bars go by. I was not quiet enough to end the fight that quick.
But there we go.
Starts over again. She can't hurt you when she's... You can't hurt her. She can't hurt you when she's just floating around like that. Pattern starts over. Summons a new wave of enemies. And from now on, it'll just be...
Goliaths.
Yeah, 4 Goliaths.
And a Mega Man or
two. Some Mega Mans. You want to take care of those. Because those are just... They're just the worst
annoying.
When they knock you off whatever combo you're trying to do.
Can Thanatos get hit while he's doing Ignorant Masses?
No.
Okay.
Thanatos is invincible while doing that. But for the rest of this, it's just Blasphemy Town.
I do like how they cringe like that.
Yeah, they're just, stop it! Quit it!
Stop it!
Stop it!
No!
Stop! It hurts! That really hurts! Stop it! Yep.
And then they do
and then they do a little AoE thing.
Yeah.
Jump on their heads.
Mario, Mega Man, all the other properties that PlayStation clearly does not own.
There we go. They're dead. Now we start the next wave. She'll appear with... Just standing still. Whatever. Because Zeke don't give a damn. He's just like, whatever.
Zeke don't care.
He just don't care. She'll summon some more Danus. It'll either be Bombers or the Ogmas. But as you can see, it's not even a contest. Just...
And she's dead.
It used to do so much damage when she's out there like that.
Was that it?
That's it. That's the end.
Sheila.
I wanted to tell Zeke, I'm happy that I met you and
Victor.
Delacroix.
Me too.
Thank you.
Zeke is also happy that he met himself.
Apparently, yes.
Remember earlier when I said this had the dumbest, worst ending song ever? We get to listen to that. I'm going to turn this volume up.
Well, Delacroix got what he wanted in the end.
Yep, he finally got back to the Shire. You can hear it in the background. It's coming in. It's so bad. I hate it. It's so dumb. Look at it. I like his pink nails. It's very fancy.
Able to save either
very fancy, Zeke. What happened to your wound on your shoulder?
Oh, it's gone.
Don't worry.
Azrael healed it on the way out.
Yeah. How nice
I'm
of him.
The only one that survived.
Let's make babies.
I'm here.
That music would be better than this. This sounds awful.
Supposedly he says, come with me. But you can put whatever you want in to make that either touching or funny. Depending on your mood. I hate this song. It's so dumb. Because the music in this game is so awesome.
And then we get cheesy date flick. This is the credits for a cheesy...
It's the worst kind of, like, horrible anime style, like, I'm trying to think of the self-affirming lyrics.
Yeah.
Like, fly away, fly so high, you can do anything if you try, just believe in yourself, and the world will fly by with you, or, you know, that kind of just horrible, like, platitudes about
self-discovery. We need to make that into a song.
And, like, especially the rather dire, I guess,
like
setting of the game.
Like, how freaking depressing this game is.
And also compared to the awesomeness of the rest of the music.
Yeah. I mean, it's got an okay guitar solo, at least.
It's fine. It's just the way the guy's voice sounds and just the horrible lyrics
Just listen to that.
Yeah. Boobs.
Take.
What? You might want to cut that out. Anyway.
Not Sephiroth.
Not Sephiroth. But yeah, it kind of reminds me of what I was telling you about Van Canto. It's Germans who are writing in English. So they know they want, like, kings and peasants and rebellion and all that stuff in their music, but they're probably not certain how all of it works.
Yeah.
So it's like, the meter's good. Let's sing it. Because I've never heard any of them speak English ever.
Yeah.
They all just talk in German and then sing English.
Or Singlish.
Singlish, yes. Because it's like whenever you sing... I'm going to keep talking because this is bad. It's like when I was at one of the international conventions for Barbershop. I was singing with a German dude and an Icelandic dude. Uh-huh. Neither of them spoke a word of English. And then we'd sing perfect English. like Barbershop perfect English. Like, it sounded like they were from the set of The Music Man.
That's funny.
So
there's the theme song. It's Fly by Live, or Live, however you want to pronounce that.
Ugh.
Apparently some sort of Japanese, like, pop singer or pop band or something. I'm not really one to comment on the specifics of early 2000 pop music in Japan, but I'm guessing that they got him because he was, like, popular or for some reason.
Well, he doesn't have necessarily bad pipes. It's just... The song
it's nasally. It says that fly so high, fly
yeah,
so high.
Yeah, and this isn't the kind of music that would complement that at all.
It's not like just the badass.
Okay, that says
ripping.
All Capcom staff. I thought it said all Capcom stuff. It's like, this is ours. This is ours. Don't take it. It's our stuff.
I'll probably drop in a bit of Azrael's theme into this here, just because it's really awesome.
Yeah, Azrael.
It sounds like Unreal Tournament music.
Oh, I love Unreal.
Good old Chaos Legion.
That's it?
Legionator! A few extras to look at.
Yeah.
This is the music that plays. This is the final result music. You get 150 million experience for beating CeeLo, which is really funny, but whatever.
But you can't use it.
Obviously don't use it for anything.
Because you can't. New game plus.
Special monsters 2. I'm guessing Delacroix doesn't count. Just think about that. One of them doesn't count.
You know what it probably was? It was probably one of the zombies and one of the Mega Mans.
Yeah, maybe so. You had to kill a Mega Man.
It wasn't Azrael and then Sela Azrael. Save clear data?
So when you beat it, you unlock hard mode. If you beat hard mode, you unlock super mode, which we'll briefly take a look at. You also get your result screen... you get access to the movie theater that you can watch in English or Japanese.
Hmm.
The first one here, the news, it just tells you what you got, so that's handy. So you can play as Arcia in a new game. You can play in hard mode. After you beat hard mode, then you can do super mode. I've obviously at this point have already beaten hard mode, but there's the movie select. You can actually watch them in Japanese or English. This first one is a really kind of superfluous, like, 2-minute documentary, which you're going to be watching about the guy singing that horrible song at the end. So,
really?
Let's listen to some more Fly.
I hate you.
By Live. Or is maybe it's Fliv by Liv. I don't know. Just listen to those lyrics.
There's clearly an old white guy. Can't he just tell them they're being weird?
Yeah. The Japanese will have none of that. They will hear none of that. You're being kind of weird. No, we're not.
Kind of weird?
You're weird.
Kind of? We're not doing enough.
You're weird. Shut up.
We need a chariot.
Might cut that out.
Might cut that out. Sorry.
But, yes.
Point is made. We need Amara. We need Amara.
Yep. Always. No one ever suspects Mara. Weird. Now, that's possibly a chick drummer.
I think it
could.
Is.
No, or it could just be a dude.
I think that's a chick. I'm going to go with chick on that
one. I think that at this point, Japanese people are actually monogendered.
Oh, okay. And it's only in their anime.
There's sort of outliers that resemble closer to female or male, depending on circumstances. Eh. But pretty much it's just, you know, just...
Japanese.
That's, you know.
The friend of mine who's worked for Japanese companies in Japan, it's like she came back and she's just like, they're so weird. You think
and
it's
then,
just...
And then
it's
that's
just,
it.
That's
like,
it.
That's it. There's no narration or anything. It's like, here's some scenes and stuff. Like, all right.
All right. There's,
sure. That's all right.
Are we going
to
watch something?
No choice but to watch the Southern Accent Man in Japanese. I have no choice. I have no choice.
この世ならざる者どもを呼び寄せるなり。この世ならざる者どもを汝に羽振り従うべし。すは混沌の軍勢なり。
Why don't the lips line up for the sinking?
I don't know. Weird.
私は生涯貴様を許すことはない。 I thought that was the main reason to watch Japanese animation. That was almost a word, Japanese.
Jabs anime.
And I thought the reason to watch anime in Japanese was so that the lips would line up.
Well, the other reason to watch it is to make you feel better about yourself, I guess. So you can look down on other people who like anime. Be like, man, you can only have to watch it in the original Japanese with subtitles. Man, dub suck.
No, you can only watch it in the original Japanese. No
subtitles. Southern accent, man. They actually have different voice actors doing each of those parts.
Yeah. I love the way they say his last name. That's actually pretty awesome.
But yes, about dubs and subs, about rant, because why not? This is my own soapbox.
Yeah.
The reason that people like subs better is because if you don't know the language, then something like bad acting doesn't come through as easily, especially if you don't know the difference. There's a little total results. So that's why it's bizarrely unfair to put that up against dubbing, especially since dubbing has gotten to the point where they actually decide to hire people that actually do it as a job instead of, oh, I don't know, Southern Accent Man.
I like Southern Accent Man. Yeah, I would hire good. Southern Accent Man.
It's fine.
Well, it's like the... What was the anime called? Italian word for brouhaha. Bacano. Bacano.
Bacano, yeah.
The firm that did all the voices for that's based out of Texas.
Mm-hmm.
And...
Well, aren't they... Well, Funimation and ADV are both Texas things, right?
Yeah.
I mean, ADV is in Houston, actually.
What are we doing?
We're starting up a little game on Super Mode real fast. Now, Super Mode...
You have a red sword.
I do.
Fire sword.
Actually. Super Mode, you have infinite magic, but you also... Everything dies in one hit, including you.
Huh.
The most amusing thing to do is really just walk around with malice. I don't quite get that far, but... We'll just kind of wander around a little bit with old Thanny here, old adult Thanatos, messing dudes up.
Wow. Everything dies in one hit.
Sure does. So it's pretty much like the end of the game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh.
A little guy stuck up there. What are you doing up there?
Hey there, what
you doing?
You're
not supposed to be up there, crazy guy.
So Super Mode is kind of like Heaven and Hell.
Yeah, it's exactly the same. Where, just like in Devil May Cry 3, your best bet is long-range weapons.
Ebony and Ivory.
Exactly.
I'm assuming Arcia would be great for Super Mode if you could.
You can.
Oh, you can.
Yeah, you can. That's an option for Arcia, too. Or you can just use infinite ignorant mass.
You can use infinite ignorant masses.
You sure can. So you have infinite MP soul anyways. So that's kind of nice. I mean, it's, you know, it's an amusing, you know, it's nice that it's there, I guess.
Yeah.
But it's kind of, you know.
Why would you?
You've already beaten the game on hard mode at this point, so.
You've already done the impossible.
Yes, you've gone through it. So might as well just kind of move on with your life at this point, which I'm prepared to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I think it put about, it was about 40 hours, it was about 30 hours, or something like 20 hours main game, 10 or 15 for this playthrough, another 5 for the Arcia run that I had done before, just on hard, play through it, got all the stats in that. So yeah, it was about 40 hours or so playing through this game.
Wow.
Getting everything, maxing everything out. It's pretty fun, though.
Yeah.
I would recommend it.
It's
I mean, give it 2 sarcastic thumbs up.
He's actually giving thumbs up.
Yeah.
While he's drinking his Delaware Punch.
Yes, delicious Delaware Punch. If you do not live in Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, or Ohio, then, well, you're going to have to import it from eBay.
Because you can't buy Delaware Punch.
You can't really buy it. It's a weird thing where, like, one of the ingredients, it's like there's a red food coloring in here that's, like, illegal in some states. I have no idea why, but, yeah, you just break all the rules if you want to import this.
Well, it's the same reason. It's probably the same kind of stuff that's why I can't get the bacon-flavored vodka sold at the specs down here. For some odd reason, it's illegal.
That's weird.
By the way, bacon-flavored vodka is delicious.
Good times. Delaware Punch actually has nothing to do with the state of Delaware. It is Delaware County, Ohio grapes that it was originally made with. Although it is technically bottled by Coke, so I mean it's not like some obscure,
yeah,
small mom and pop company.
No, you know, no,
Coca-Cola,
it's the Activision of the soda world.
Yeah, is Coke still around? Is that still a thing?
Shut up. I honestly could
not
remember.
They make, you know, lots of famous drinks like Coca-Cola. Like, oh yeah, I guess so.
That's not quite the same, good sir.
All right. There's a guilty guilt. Gil-a-dil-a-dil-a-dil-a.
But do you get to keep Thanatos?
No, you don't get to keep Thanatos. Oh. The game, I mean, the game goes through normal. It's normal paces. Skip. Ultimate crest broken. Sad face.
Skip.
Skip. Call that points that
don't matter.
Yep. Everything's made up. Points don't matter.
Went to see some improv comedy celebrate my birthday. It was really good.
It's the same one, Comedy Sports?
Yeah, Comedy Sports. Yeah, love that place.
It's fun times.
It was fun times. The guy who was doing the voice was really getting into it. Having a lot of fun messing with the ref, making him make mistakes. It was actually pretty good.
Good times.
It was fun. How much of this are we watching?
I just put it in here.
Oh, okay.
Stop at some point. I just go until I die. I just get poked by a say a dogda or something.
It's probably just a dogda at this point.
Well, they're just called Zerdogas. There is no Dogas.
Oh. Right.
The Dogda family, I suppose. Slice, slice, slice.
But you don't have any of your cool powers.
Maybe
anymore.
This wasn't shown off the first time in the game, but I was going to do it here. Nah, I guess I don't. If you kill that Ogma there before he runs all the way down, you'll get, you know, there, I died.
Game end.
Nope. We're done.
Game end.
Game's over.
Yay!
No more Chaos Legion.
Chaos Legion's done forever.
Woot, woot, woot. Legionator! I don't have an ending.
How do you end this?
It's whatever. I end it by pressing the stop.
Stop.